Major General, you've brought these two weapons to kind of make the case.
An illustration.
And as an illustration, exactly, as a symbolic representation.
To back up all that things
I understand,
I have the list here.
I understand, sir.
Yes.
But what is not yet clear to the public is where is this money going to be channeled through? Is it strictly through the Nigerian military? Is it the office of the NSA? There should be some clarity. We understand that these are sensitive issues. We understand that we can't have all the details, but some level of understanding, because right now the reality is we're coming from a background where such funds were used to fund various election activities. We are 1.5 years away from an election. And even if one disregards Governor Fayose's statements as mere political rhetoric, there still is a concern, because of the history, about how these funds are going to be used. What can you tell the public, if anything at all?
Before I tell the public anything, I want to say two things. Yes, the concern is normal, it's human. That is it. If you had malaria in the past, because you stayed in the place that is infested with mosquitoes, with you should be afraid. And then again, if you are properly treated and you have seen that the treatment has worked, you should also be encouraged that the treatment has worked. The encouragement is that we have new service chiefs, we have new type of management in the armed forces. And I tell you that, look, these funds given to the armed forces, given to the military to be used, is going to be perfectly used for whatever purpose it has been meant for. And that is the assurance I want to tell the public. And again, it is because based on the needs and wants requirement. It is not just anyhow thing. It is not just that it's just coming from the blues. It has been progress report. How are you doing? We brief the appropriate superior authority. We brief them on what we do, our needs. What if we get this? It would have been better like this, based on and the strategies put in place, because every strategy is matched up with the equipment and the administrative requirements. And that is what it is. So that is why the public should be rest assured that we have a new set of management as it is now in the armed forces of Nigeria, and whatever resources is provided to ensure that insurgency and terrorism is brought to an appreciable, eliminatable level. Eliminated, it will be done.
Major General, the security sector is a very large operation. And essentially, your assurance to Nigerians is that, yes, there is a new president, yes, there is a new administration, yes, there are new service chiefs, but we, in such a large sector, you have a lot of different cadres. No one is more aware of that than you.
Yes.
Now, these processes run through a lot of people's hands. And the question I want to ask you is, within the military arms, have there been any measures that have put in place institutionally to ensure that those officers, those middle cadre officers, for example, middle to senior cadre officers, that these funds are going to be passing through, will be aligned with the thinking, potentially, of the new management that you're referring to?
By the training in the military, if the head fails, the body will fail. There is always a leadership. We attach a lot of importance to leadership, and it goes down the ladder. Of course, there might be little issues here and there, but I tell you that this administration, since July 2015, has virtually, if I would say, transformed the military. It's not that the military was bad, by my own assessment. Yes, people can say whatever they are saying, but looking at the grand directive given by the commander-in-chief, who himself, by the grace and special mercies of God, was a military man who also had been in combat before. This is a leadership style. This is, and of course, it is not because it is the right thing to do. That is what the armed forces, from the chief of defense staff, all of them are doing. And I'm assuring you that we do leadership by example, not by compulsion. You don't compel anybody. So whoever is going to be involved, that is by you, because of course, procurement and other things, yes, of course, this, some middle-level cadre officers will be involved in the races. I assure you that nobody, none of them, will go out of its ways to become fraudulent or otherwise. I want to assure Nigerians about that.
Major General, as these, as we've seen this rise in expenditure that I've alluded to, there's kind of an irony that emerges, because on the one hand, expenditures are increasing, and on the other hand, the federal government is telling Nigerians, We've essentially, or more or less, defeated Boko Haram, or have gone a long way to defeating. Now, if that is the case, wouldn't the resources be largest at the beginning? Why are they growing rather than reducing if we are indeed successful in the war on insurgency, as you say?
Well, if I will use my personal knowledge of economics, I'm not an economist, but you say resources, at the beginning, yes, we are the resources. We are all living witnesses in this country. Thank God my salary has never been delayed, other people in the other sectors. But there are other things that, you know, maybe overhead and other, we would not come in time. Not because the government does not want to give, they don't have. It was not there. So now if this money was there when the administration came, and then we presented our needs and wants, well, I believe it would have been done. So now, but now let me also stress one thing here. You know, the finishing of every project costs more than even the initial construction after the foundation. I am an engineer, combat engineer into construction. It plays out in every aspect of life. We are now getting to the finishing. You started a building, the foundation might have cost you 1 million naira. The superstructure may cost you 500,000. But come to finishing, when you are talking about roofing, putting all the, you know, dotting the T's and I, painting, fixing all the aesthetics, you may require more than 5 million naira. That is the situation we are now. Because we need all this specialized equipment, talking about drones, talking about things like the flat bottom bulls, the special, we are talking about five Mushak aircraft by Air Force from Pakistan, and we are jubilating, we are happy. Yes, it's good. Look at what they did at Kenji, refurbishing our Alpha jet engines and all, with what would have cost us several millions of dollars. Those are the kind of things we are talking about, that when these funds come, now we are getting to the finishing. What about the MRAP, we call them mine resistance armor protected vehicles. We have infantry recce vehicles, we have GPS, all modern things that we need now to be able to use effectively. And those are the things, you talk about administration. So like I said, I premised against the illustration I made, when you are finishing any project, just like a building project, it's supposed to be more expensive.
Major General, President Muhammadu Buhari has been on public record as saying that the farmer and herdsman conflicts is not merely a Nigerian issue, that it has to do with foreign terrorist groups operating in the West African and the Sahara, potentially flooding into Nigeria under the guise of herdsmen. Now, the question I want to ask you is, the definition under which this money is now being released, which is Boko Haram insurgency, can be quite vague, and it can mean a lot of different things to a lot of different people. And the question I have to ask you is, with these neighboring countries, even if Nigeria is as competent and as equipped as any army in the world, and the neighboring countries are not, then there's going to be a problem of infiltration into Nigeria because the other bordering countries aren't doing what they're supposed to do. So what I want to ask you is, with this money that is now being released, is there going to be a move by the Nigerian government to potentially equip other people's militaries and other people's logistics in terms of this war on insurgency, or is it just Nigeria that's going to benefit from this money?
The answer is no. The money was approved by Nigeria's National Economic Council. Not by ECOWAS, not by Lake Chad Basin. Of course, there is a fund, you know, being donated to Lake Chad Basin, which has been coming in bids. Yes, so it is not going to be channeled or directed at any of that. But again, if foreigners migrate from their own countries and get into our territory, who are they going to hurt? It's we. So we need to protect our people. We need to protect ourselves. So whatever we are going to do is to protect ourselves. Of course, I'm not saying that this fund, yes, it's not for any other thing apart from insurgency. But who are the insurgents? Who are the terrorists? It can be an Idoma man like me. It can be a Fulani man. It can be an Igbo man. It can be a Hausa man. So if any tribe turns himself to an insurgent or a terrorist, we handle you squarely as a terrorist.
Major General, I just want to thank you for coming on Sunrise Daily this morning.
Thank you.
So we're going to take a short break. Be with us as we come back in a moment.